both my home and my university occupy the unceded homelands of the Catawba, Tuscarora, and Lumbee peoples. I would like to encourage everybody to visit the URL native-land.ca, where you can type in a city name or a zip code or something into the search, and it will show you the names of the native territories that you occupy. So if you want to do that, I encourage you to do that and share in chat what you learn. Land acknowledgements are, I think, really important for, especially, you know, today is Indigenous Peoples Day. So I think it's especially important that we all try to engage in the work of learning more about Indigenous people and acknowledging that it's not just a historical, like, they once lived here and now they're gone, but that these people are still around and are part of our present day. And there are still material harms being perpetrated that we should work to rectify. So I encourage you to learn more about that. And I've given some resources on the slide. So acknowledging the land you occupy is the start. It's just the beginning of the journey, not the end. In particular for this community, there's a really cool group of people working on Indigenous AI. So I've provided a link to that. So acknowledging the work of Indigenous scholars is really important. Learn more about them, definitely. And I also wanted to point out the book Network Sovereignty, Building the Internet Across Indian Country, in part because we're all making use of internet infrastructure to have this meeting. And it's not just where we all each are physically, but also the internet we're using to communicate with each other that participates in these acts of colonialism. With that said, I want to briefly introduce our co-chairs. So I have the honor of organizing this workshop with Joe Osborne and Ian Horswell, who will now briefly introduce themselves.
Hi, everybody. I'm Joe. I really think Chris should be first on the list, but I'm happy to introduce first. My pronouns are he, him. I'm at Pomona College, which is near Los Angeles. I do a lot of work in game design, formal methods, kind of been in between game studies and AI. And lately I've been doing more stuff with computer vision or optical character recognition kind of models applied to images from games. In my teaching, I look mostly at classical AI. I'm also doing a really fun course that Michael Greenberg put together on teaching our second introductory course in the Coke Proof Assistant. So it's super fun. I'm happy to talk about it if people want to know more. And I've been really into Splatoon recently as like a shooter that actually has art direction and sound design. It's really good.
Hi, I'm Ian. I go by he or they. My research is in declarative languages for PCG and interactive narrative. I teach our big intro programming course this quarter that has, I guess, 400 students learning Racket, and the game design and development course that has 230 students learning Unity. I also teach a course on AI and experimental narrative where I'm teaching declarative programming primarily for tabletop role-playing games and trying to do outreach to students who aren't programmers, like theater majors, creative writing majors, and so on. And I have not had time to play games much recently other than some tabletop games. So I'll give you the names of at least some languages that I've made that are used in games. My friends from SomaSim Games will be talking about their use of Bottle and CatSat in the main conference on Friday. And I have a procedural content generation declarative language called Imaginarium that I use with non-programmers.
And my name's Chris Martins. My pronouns are they, them. I tried to wear my most appropriate queer t-shirt today. And my research is about interactive narrative authoring tools, PCG, social simulation, and solver-rated creativity support. I teach courses mostly related to those topics, including interactive narrative, game AI, and generative methods or procedural content generation. And recently, I have enjoyed the games Heaven's Vault, Disco Elysium, and Bonfire Peaks. And the first one being especially relevant because we have the main developer of Heaven's Vault for our keynote speaker today, which I am so excited about. I have adored this game in so many ways. And so that is, I have a couple more points before we get to the, I got ahead of myself a bit there, a couple more points before we get to the keynote speaker. But we have a wonderful schedule that spans 2 days. The first day is going to be a little bit shorter than the second day. I'm hoping we'll get started with the invited talk in just a couple minutes at the 45 mark. And then we'll finish up at 2020 GMT. And then tomorrow we'll have 4 sessions. The first one is going to be just an invited talk. And then there's going to be 3 sessions of all of the sessions are kind of otherwise a mix of demos, preliminary work, position papers, and conversation starters. So for those of you who are not familiar with the conversation starter concept, because it's a little bit of a different thing for this workshop, I'm mostly going to basically leave it to the presenters to decide how they want to facilitate those. But the goal is that it's going to be a much higher ratio of discussion time to presenting time. So they'll kind of present for a few minutes to set up a discussion topic, maybe provide some questions or, you know, things for you to discuss. And then you'll gather together in small groups, which will be set up with the tables that are throughout the room. And then at a designated time, each group will come up to the podium and kind of present what they talked about as a small group. The other thing is that on Wednesday, for the first day of the main conference, we are to give a workshop report for Plie, and I would very much appreciate it if you all could help me with that. So you should have edit permissions. Anybody who has the link should be able to edit these slides, and I encourage you to be bold with your edits, to especially adding things. If you can avoid deleting things, that'd probably be good, especially if other people have added things. But please, I put in some templates here. You know, if you identify kind of major themes that come out throughout the conference, feel free to make a slide about that. If you have any attendee takeaways, like if you learn a new cool idea that you maybe write down in your own personal notebook, then I would also appreciate if you would add it to the slide and say, hey, here's something new and cool I learned at this workshop. Or if there's just anything else you think would be worth sharing with the general aid audience, I would very much appreciate you contributing to this because this is the first time this workshop is run and we kind of want to get a good sense for how it goes for everybody. And maybe show the rest of aid what they missed out on if they didn't come. So that is, I think, about it. For the keynote today, my plan for Q&A is going to be kind of similar, a little bit to what I talked about for the conversation starters. So John will present, and then there will be a sort of a two-part Q&A. So the first part of the Q&A will be table discussion. So either sit in one of the chairs around one of the circular tables in the room, so that you have a group to talk to, or otherwise, if you just kind of go to a part of the room, if all the tables are taken, if you go to a part of the room where you're just like near, where your avatar is near a group of other avatars, then that also functions as a group that you can participate in discussion with. And then you'll have 4 minutes basically to share your first impressions or your questions with with your group mates, and then you can use that as a to like kind of debug the questions or like bounce ideas off each other. And then after that 4 minutes, there will be another 4 minutes where you'll actually go up to the mics on either side of the stage here and ask your questions to the speaker. Oh, good. Joe has figured out how to record. That is awesome. If you do not want your talk to be recorded for any reason, please let us know. But otherwise, we hope to record these things and release them later so that the public has the opportunity to, at least the speaking portions, not the, probably the discussion portions will be kept unrecorded, I think, by default. So yeah, and if you like this Q&A format and you want to use it for your own presentation, you're welcome to just try to stick overall generally within the time slot you've been given.